Salutations, friends. Welcome back to my channel. I put up my little kitty fabric today because today and the next few days is going to be an extremely busy day because we're trying to get out holiday orders and I need to be able to get to my shipping stuff. So this is going to be a little vloggy day. I kind of wanted to take you guys what my day is like. Not talking to you guys, but actually working. Because some of you guys have actually asked about my business, how I run my business, you know, and things like that. So I figured I'd take you on one of the busiest days of the year for me, which is like the week before Christmas. I have hundreds of orders to get out today. My husband and I have hundreds of glasses to make. We have a pretty good system down to where we're not so running around like a chicken with our head cut off, but I was kind of wanted to take you around today. A not beauty video, but I thought it might be fun if you guys saw where I work and how I work. So yeah, I hope you enjoy this video, this little vlog. Also, because I don't know if I have time to film a beauty video today, I'm expecting a very special package today for tomorrow's video. So something special for tomorrow. So I figured if today's kind of a blah video, tomorrow's video will be extra special. So yeah. Real quickly too, I've gotten a variety of negative comments on my videos, and rightfully so, about this mess right here. A lot of you guys say, ooh, gross, how can you have a beauty channel and have this stuff back here? It's not ideal. Actually, the reason why I film here with this is because there's this giant window right there. Let me see if I can turn you guys around. There you go. See? Lots of natural light. Now what we're doing right now, the reason why that area on the other side is so messed up is actually I have a new computer that we're moving over here, and so all of our stuff is there, is over there, and it's just been a stressful morning. I've been cleaning behind desks, and as you know, that's like where dust lives, and it's just been, ugh, it's been weird. But so today is like super busy and also completely reorganizing. Now this area I wanted to talk about because a lot of you guys think this is gross, and it is. Right here, this is where I keep, figured since you guys see it a lot of videos, let's see if I can grab it, that I put on glasses. And then what we do is we have a sandblasting machine and it blasts away this clear film, and then this is the design that's etched onto the glasses. And so this is where we keep all the spares, because we have to do them in sheets. And so if there's any extra room, because the sheets are very expensive, we fill it with extra designs that sell, or that, you know, are weird to fit on their own sheet. So this right here, all of this is up here. These are mat boards for when I ship, ship prints. These are these, and then down here is a miscellaneous bills and invoices. So this area is very much kind of like my dumping ground. Over here is just a variety of different things in here. I have my mom needle felted me Gunter. I love it. My mom and I both needle felt. She needle felts amazingly, I needle felt so. But she likes to make me little toys and surprise me. Then I've got Connie, Steven, and Finn, who's, until this area is reorganized and nice looking, it's going to be kind of messy. This is my resolution next year, is to get this looking nice, but I won't be filming, at least in front of this. I'm going to build something here. My husband's going to build something here to go down, because after like test filming all over the house, literally, this is the best spot to film. Like, we went around with my camera, because I have a nice DSLR camera that I'm going to film on, and we have lights, and we have all this equipment, and we were, like, setting up the lights, and filming, and filming, and filming, and then there's just something about natural light that just looks so much better. So, I'm gonna be filming here. My husband's going to be building something to pull down. That's going to be next year. I know I keep pulling this off, but actually my camera is going to be pulled out tomorrow. I'm really excited. That's one of the reasons why I wanted to get the computer set up over here to make editing this video easier, because it's a very special video. And yeah, so I'm pretty much like, this is a mess. This up here is pins for my artwork. This is jewelry supplies. Down here is jewelry supplies. I also own a pearl business. I design pearl jewelry. I wear it all the time. I link it below. It's pretty much the only self-promotion I do. So if you ever see jewelry, West Pearls, check us out. We have really nice stuff and our prices are pretty freaking low. But yeah, like this is like my work area. Right here, over here, this is an entire ginormous mess. Please understand that whenever I say something's a mess, it's not like, oh, it's a mess. It's a mess because everything that was under here that was in storage is now up here. So like it's gonna be a busy day, but here, let me take
you. Okay, see what I mean? Like all of this stuff was in storage underneath my desk in really nice storage. There's a random pearl. And because we're adding a new computer and a new sound system down there, all of this stuff had to come up here. And unfortunately, because we're in the middle of season, space is really limited. So the only space was my nice clean desk. This is my Wacom tablet. This was a gift from my husband for my birthday, like last year. It's gorgeous. This is my computer screen and where I do all my digital work. Now, what I do when I make paintings or when I create paintings is I will always make a digital reference first. It'll vary slightly from the actual painting. Generally, it'll be the same lighting or the same tone or the same expression. And I'll use that as reference for my paintings. So then I'll have two pieces. I'll have an original digital and then I'll have a painting, and that's, you know, has worked pretty well for me. So that's why I love this. And then that's my printer. That's my other printer, and that's my breakfast. Oh my gosh, I don't know why I'm showing you all of this. I'm only so many subscribers, but seriously, this is because of you guys, but in a good way. The reason why I have this computer coming, the reason why I'm doing this giant mess is literally so I can finally edit and get you guys better footage and film better videos, because everyone's commenting on how gross this looks, and it does look gross, and I really just wanted to, get you guys better footage. So you're going to see the before. This is the before. That's one of my purses. I just kind of put them up there because I grab and go. Like I said, I don't treat my designer purses really nice, which is why I only have a few. But yeah, but my yard's gorgeous. Look how pretty that is. And this isn't my, I mean, it is my yard, but this is literally because my mother-in-law puts so much work. And if you see, there's a little house down there. That's her house. And that's the guest house. And that's also where my husband and I have our little fabrication laboratory. We have a CNC printer, our CNC router, 12x8 CNC router. We have like two 3D printers. We have a kiln. We have a foundry. We have a laser cutter. We have a lot of equipment because we're really expanding our business. And then in my mother-in-law's house and her garage is our sandblasting studio, where we have all of our equipment there.
Also, during season, we lose our house completely. Let me turn on this light. It's so dark. Sorry, my hands are all shaky. We literally lose our house. Because we work from home, our house becomes our work station. So I'm going to, like, everything that we have that's nicely decorated, there's a giant bottle of booze, literally gets pushed aside up into everything, and then our living space becomes our workspace.
I'm showing you guys this because it's really messy, but I kind of wanted to show you guys how I work and give you guys a glimpse into what it's like working for yourself and working from home. Because a lot of people think it's glamorous and you sit in your pajamas, but you really lose a lot of yourself when you do this. And that's kind of like the point of this video. First off, there's Pancakes. There's Pancakes. You see him in a lot of videos because he's like curious. He's such a good boy. Anyway, okay, so literally this is where my husband and I live every day for like hours a day. This is where we eat. This is where we work. We put all the glasses together here. Then my husband brings them over to the garage, or the, hold on. The sandblasting studio, there we go. So we literally just sit here. So all of our nice decorations and all the way that we have our house nicely set up, literally it's trashed. Our house is completely trashed. Like, here's our pretty Christmas tree that we can't have lights because of this cat, because he will literally eat them and we don't want him to get hurt. And then here's inventory that we need to create glassware with to sell. And then here's stuff for glassware, and it's just everything is on the floor. It's kind of embarrassing, but again, I wanted to show you guys what it's like to work from home. Also, look at this LSP blanket my mom made me. upside down, but it's really cute. She made this for me. My mom is amazing. She's so talented, and it gets me angry when she doesn't think she's talented. Mom, I know you watch my videos. Stop doubting yourself.
Anyway, so yeah, that's kind of like my thing. I'm not the best interior designer. In fact, I have absolutely no interior designer. Oh my gosh, I have to show you something. A wild, wild
Gigi. This is a Gigi. This is my husband's cat. I mean, this
is all of our cats. He is,
he's very stoic. He's also very whiny. He tolerates me, but he loves my husband. Which is fine, because this is my husband's favorite cat. My husband and I like black cats. I mean, we love all kitties.
But we feel like black cats don't get enough love, especially when it comes to adoptions and rescues. So anytime we can rescue or adopt a black cat, we do.
Yeah, our house is a mess. We have litter box. We have to move litter boxes out of the way. I mean, when you have five cats, you have a lot of litter boxes. So they're like in our living space. Our house looks like a warehouse. Like if you could walk in and be like, oh, you guys are disgusting. And it's like, no, it's just the season. But like the holiday season, everyone expects to have really nice houses and everything's pretty and decorated. And we're the exact opposite. Our house is clean and presentable and really, really nice until like the end of October. And we start getting all of our inventory and all of our blank work, and then we start making glasses, and we literally just turn into what looks like horrible slobs, because this is how we work from home. And so, like, it's the working from home is really, really fantastic, and I really enjoy it, and it's very fulfilling, and I love the fact that we do this for ourselves. We make a decent amount of money. It's really awesome, especially when we do wedding glassware and customers send us back pictures of them at their wedding with their glassware. It's just really, really rewarding, but it's definitely hard. It's hard on me and my husband, like, I don't want to say like relationship-wise, but it is, because the thing is since we work from home and we both work together, we are with each other every single freakish moment. And as blessed as I am for that, because I love my husband, he's such an amazing person, it gets tiring. Sometimes it's nice when you go to a job and you come home to your husband or your wife or your boyfriend or your girlfriend or whoever is your partner, your companion, and you just de-stress and you vent. And we don't get that luxury. Oh, there's another luxury. Hold on.
This is Muta.
Come here, baby. He's the sweetest boy.
Anyway, yeah, it's hard. So, like, holiday season, family's over, friends over, throwing parties, beautiful house, beautifully decorated. Mm-mm. But I kind of wanted to touch on this again. I'm going to set this down to where maybe I'm not completely driving you guys nuts with it being. There we go. The lighting's in here. It's weird because we have lights up there. I don't know if you can see it. That's a light so we can see. Literally, there's a giant, look. That's a light so that I can work because I can't stay in the dark. Every single freakishly thing in our house becomes a disaster because of season. Like, there are so many, let me grab them. There's so many things that we need to make. Oh my gosh, so many glasses we need to make. We have probably, this week, I have to make probably about 1,000 glasses. And that's make, so that's make these guys, we make these stencils, these take time, put them on the glasses, tape them so that when we etch them, this part doesn't get etched. This one, it was a mess up, which happens. We, you know, there is loss. And then take that off, clean them, dry them, polish them, package them, and drop them off to the post office. Everything we do minus the actual sandblasting in this house. For a while, we actually considered renting a warehouse, and we can afford it, but my husband and I are kind of like homebodies, and so we're okay with having a messy house and saving literally like $25,000 a year. So if you wonder where I can afford the stuff that I buy, like my perfume or my makeup or my skincare, it's because of decisions like this. It's because I'm okay with a messy house for 2 or 3 months out of the year. because that's where we cut corners and we're okay with saving money. So again, if you ever look at my videos and you're like, wow, you have a lot of expensive stuff, it's because I have a messy house during Christmas. Literally $25,000 we save by literally working here and not having a warehouse space. It is how it is.
Also, the other thing is that we are currently, this house is a 1-1. Again, this house is a historic house. There's a little panel outside. My mother-in-law, her father and grandfather built this house. They built the house she lives in now. This is a historic property in Fort Lauderdale. It's absolutely beautiful. Mother-in-law is a historian. There's a lot to do with that. So the thing with this house is that this was built as a bungalow, like a vacation home for a single, like a couple. And since my husband and I live here, and she raised her family here and it worked for her, but our needs are different than her needs when she was raising her family and like my husband and my brother-in-law. So our needs are different. So we had to build an entire kitchen in the bedroom that... Yeah, so our kitchen, which is messy, I'm not going to show you messy kitchen, it doesn't pertain to this video, that's just because of the party and our kitchen's disaster. I'm going to put this down so I'm not, like, super duper, like, giving you guys, like, crazy nausea. Our kitchen is a big kitchen, it's really nice, so we turn the bedroom into the kitchen, but the issue with that is the bathroom is in the kitchen, which is weird. So the next thing we have to do is close that door and build a wall. Oh my gosh, I sound like, I don't like saying that. Brings back bad things. Drywall and then add some more storage there because we have no storage in this house. Put another door in here so that you can get in from the living room and not from the kitchen. And we just added, it's not completely done yet, all the plumbing and fixtures and the big stuff's in, but we added a second bathroom upstairs into like a loft. And it's really, really nice. It's got this giant tub that lights up, literally lights up, and has a room of therapy because my husband, he goes extra, which is really cute. If he thinks I'll like something, he will go all out for me, which is really very generous and wonderful of him. And then we have, the bathroom part, but we have to build storage, we have to build a door. So the other reason why this house is so messy and unfortunately it's crazy is we're also in the middle of like not renovating but remodeling a little bit so that my husband and I could start a family in this house because it is a 1-1. There's rooms upstairs, that's the bedroom and the attic. The attic is filled with my mother-in-law's stuff and my brother-in-law's stuff and some of my stuff, but most of it is my brother-in-law, my mother-in-law, and that's fine because this is her house. She's very generous and lets us live here, and this is where my brother-in-law grew up, and there's no reason for his stuff to not be here, but unfortunately it's getting to the point where we're gonna have to spend weeks going through all that stuff and bringing it up to him in Orlando and having her go through it, and she's very busy. And if we start a family, like when we start a family, because we're definitely thinking about starting it soon, it's going to require a lot more renovation. So we're trying to get all of the essentials done, like the kitchen and the bathrooms, and just making this house livable so that we are comfortable here forever, because we're not going anywhere. There's no need. His family's lived here for 100 years, unless something really tragic happened, or like, because we live on the water, in case the river like raises up like 15 feet and like completely floods her entire house. We're not going anywhere, and it's fine. There's nothing wrong with it. I know this video is really long-winded, but I haven't ever really like talked to you guys. I mean, I kind of briefly talked to you about some of this stuff, but I really wanted you to see the behind the scenes of me. I mean, I don't have a lot of followers, but again, you guys, seriously, I say this every single freaking video, and I mean it. I never thought I'd have more than 10 followers. I thought maybe someone feels sorry for me and I'd have like 11, but I thought my 10 followers are going to be like my friends and my family. So the fact that I almost have 400 of you guys at this point is, you guys, it makes me so happy, especially a lot of you guys who continuously come back to my videos and comment and we reply to each other and we have conversations. And some of you guys I've talked to outside of YouTube for text messages and you found me on other forums. You guys,
I love you guys so much. It makes me so happy. I will read your comments to my husband. I'll be like, look what this person said. He's like, they said that about you? And I'm like, ah, you make me so, so happy. I never thought, whenever I saw other YouTubers say that, I'm like, that's so cheesy. Like, how? And then, like, it happens, and you guys, you don't understand. I mean, you do understand, because a lot of you guys are creators as well. But it's uplifting, you know? I never thought I'd have... I thought maybe, again, maybe 11. And I thought maybe if I get really big on YouTube, I'll have like 50. So thank you all so much for your continued support. Again, thank you. I mean, I keep saying it, but I feel like we have like a fun little group here. And like I said before, I'm not just talking about my subscribers. I see a lot of you guys commenting and being active on the community that I think is our community, which is like the skincare, beauty, fragrance community. I see a lot of you guys on the videos I frequent, and you know, and then I frequent your videos, and we all frequent each other's videos, and I love that. I'm not saying it's like my community, like Christian's family. It's more like our community. I go to your videos, I comment on your videos, you comment on my videos, we both comment on somebody else's videos. It's just this beautiful community, and I love it. So I'm really excited to see this grow, and there's actually a bunch of you guys that I love watching. Excuse me. And you guys have gotten so many more subscribers these past few weeks. Keep it up. Keep it up. I love it. I love seeing everyone. I love seeing you all succeed. It makes me so happy. So yeah. Anyway, I think I'm going to end this video here just because I think I'm rambling on and on and on. There's some Harry Potter. There's Appa. There's my wand. Here's this kitty. Look at his nose. I'm sorry. There we go. So this video is more behind the scenes. I know I said that before on how my house looks during season. I will probably give you guys a house tour once we're done renovating the bathroom upstairs, because it's really pretty. My dad pretty much did it all. He's really amazing. And I'll show you the house, because our house is really interesting. We're very eclectic. This room we designed based off of Dumbledore's office, and then a house, one of the stores in Diagon Alley. And then I just keep getting things that look shiny. I'm like a kitty. And I just keep putting them here. So this is like the shiny area. Pillows from our wedding, cat curtains because cat pillow, because of Gigi, he's like the theme of our house is black cats because of that cat. So we get a lot, anytime anyone sees black cat things, they get them for us. So my mother-in-law got me these curtains and we got matching pillows. So once season is over and everything is back to it being pretty and eclectic, I will do a proper house tour if you guys want. Let me know. If you don't care, I won't do it. I'll take you to my art room. I'll take you upstairs. I don't know if I'll take you into our bedroom. Not because I'm like against you guys being in there. It's just small and green. It's really just like a bed. Because like I said, this is an older house, so we don't have big spacious rooms. We have small rooms. Small rooms. And we have a king size bed. So it's literally like there's this bed and like it's not pretty. It's just when we don't really spend time in there. We like go to sleep, we wake up, and we come downstairs. So it's really just a green room. So I mean, if you wanted to see it, I can take you in there. I don't care. But I'll take you on a house tour when everything's set up and nice, if you want to see how it looks most of the time, not in crazy season disgusting mode. But yeah, this is what it's like to work from home. And I'm gonna be completely real with you guys. It's probably like this for anybody, no matter what you do. It might not be into the extreme that we have, where literally everything is a mess all the time. But the thing is like your work takes over pretty much everything. It takes over your living space. Even if you just work on a computer, like you're gonna have your computer set up, or you're going to, you know, have anything that you need at your disposal right in front of you. It's hard to separate work from home. I keep looking at this glass. I get really easily distracted, if you haven't noticed. It's really hard. And see, my mother-in-law works from home too. She's a historian. She writes books. She gives lectures. So she's constantly doing research in her house. So none of us really ever leave. the house ever, but her house is beautiful. And if she gives me permission, I'd love to take you guys to her house. She's got artwork everywhere. She has artifacts. Her house is been in magazines, and people come from all over the world to see her house and the yard. So maybe I'll do like a yard houses tour. I don't know. I'd have to ask her permission for that. Also, because since she has artifacts and it's museums, I have to make sure I can actually film it, because if you're going to a museum and like you can't take photographs because it's part of private collections, like a lot of her stuff goes to museums. I know that she has a large collection that's in the Denver Museum of Art right now. I think she's doing a current exhibit in Miami she's working on. So I have to make sure I can actually have permission. Like, I need specific permission, not because she wouldn't let me, but because it's in a lot of different places and it comes and goes. And I just need to make sure that I'm not doing anything that could hurt her collections or her reputation as a curator and a historian and with her her archive and things like that. So yeah, it sounds a little bit weird. If you knew us, you understand a little bit more. I don't want to get too into it, but this is just the life it is when you work from home. Your personal life goes away and your work life is literally 100%. I don't ever have a time off other than when I do YouTube videos, which is why I love doing them so much. Because it is different than making glasses all day. As soon as I'm done with this video, I'm literally going to get to work on the glasses, because that's what I have to do to make sure that everybody who trusted us with their Christmas orders get their orders on time. So that being said, thank you if you have decided to watch this video. I don't know if you have decided to sit through this entire thing. If you did, thank you. Sorry for the weird lighting. I know this light is very harsh and doesn't look very good. This is why I don't film in here very often, because it kind of ages my face way more than I like it to. I like the natural light. But sitting through everything, sitting through my rambling, sitting through my mess, I'm probably going to get negative comments. I'm probably going to be people who are like, you're a slob. That's so disgusting. How can you live like this? It's hard. I don't normally live like this. Our house is usually very clean and neat. But Christmas time, all bets are off. So if you have any questions, if you want me to go into like crazy in depth on starting your own business, I'm talking about like marketing, I'm talking about taxes, I'm talking about legalese, where to sell your stuff, what kind of business you're running. Because I have, like, we have the glassware business, we have the pearl business, I do t-shirt design, I do graphic design, I do freelance graphic design, I am also a painter and a sculptor. So we do a lot of stuff, and requires a lot of paperwork. And we are a legitimate business, so we have to pay all the fun taxes. So, I mean, the thing is like, this isn't a hobby, this is a career for us. So if you, this is something you're interested in, if you want to know how to start your business, even if you have questions on sandblasting glassware, we have launched the careers of many of our competitors. Like, I'm always kind of like wary to say that. I don't like it, but people have literally ripped us off 100%, like on our designs, like on my original designs. Also, we are illuminatedlion.com if you want to check us out. I wouldn't worry about buying anything if you want for Christmas. There's no way it'll make it to you on time. But yeah, I mean, I'll link all of our stuff below if you're interested to see what we do. Again, I'm not linking any of this to get you guys to buy. But again, if you have any questions, oh my gosh, this video is going to be so long. I'm so sorry. But I think I'm going to leave everything in. I don't know. Maybe. I just like to talk. But if you have any questions on any of the stuff and you want to see what we do, I will have my glassware business for you down there. It'll be Illuminated Lion. I will show you my pearl jewelry I design and create and make all the pearl jewelry. And my husband does all the photography and he does such a terrific job. So that'll be linked below. And I'll also link some of my websites for my t-shirt design and my artwork if you guys are interested, just to see. Again, because a lot of people are like, oh, you have such a nice collection of fragrance and makeup and skincare, and if you want to see how I afford it, it'll give you an idea. So if you have any questions on starting your own business, if you want to see any of my stuffs, and if you enjoyed this video, comment, like, subscribe, do all that fun stuff. It's fun. I'm fun, except this video is boring I've been rambling for 10 minutes, and that's supposed to be my outro. It's supposed to be like a minute. It's like 9 minutes and 13 seconds. It's right there. So I'm going to end this video right now. I'm pretty much hoping you guys have a fantastic, fantastic day. If you watch this video again, if you suffer through the entire thing, thank you. Thank you to all my new subscribers. And thank you to all the people who have continuously come back and comment and participate in the conversation of skincare, beauty, fragrance with me. I love talking with all you guys. And I will see you guys tomorrow. So bye.
You got a sleepy cat. I'm not going to pet him because he's sleeping.